That's a carpet, right? It certainly is. Yep, walking like a person. Let's pretend we didn't see anything. And I thought Wonderland was strange. That's Erica's, right? It certainly is. Yep, walking like a carpet. Let's pretend we... Never mind, we don't have time for this. Let's go. The treasure is forbidden. Touch nothing but the lamp. What was that? It sounded like a warning. First things first, we need to deal with these heartless. Right. Bag of jeans. So, there's treasure. Yeah, up ahead. Then we'd better hurry. Stop. Hey, Xehanort. Xehanort? What are you doing? Me? Aren't you supposed to be looking for Vore? Oh, we are. You were just asked to fetch a lamp to save this world. So were we. Xehanort, maybe you were right about Jafar. The world is in trouble. That much is true. But I sensed darkness inside Jafar, and he's desperate to get his hands on the lamp. Darkness? So he tricked us? All I know is that when he took my hand, I felt his greed. He covets power, and he'll stop at nothing to obtain it. Even overthrow the Sultan? I guess we're done here then. Let's keep searching for the lamp. Why? We don't owe that guy anything. Not for him. I think the lamp is essential for maintaining this world's order. Really? Why is that? Well, let me start from the beginning. Okay. So, you're saying the upperclassmen are after the lamp? She said way more than that. Let me get this straight. For whatever reason, the upperclassmen are trying to steal what's essential to each world's order. Erd thinks that this lamp Jafar is after is it, and that the upperclassmen may come to take it for themselves. Got it, that's what I said. Then let's keep looking for the lamp, and we'll deal with whatever happens when or if it happens. Improvising. I like it. I must be rubbing off on you. I sure hope not. Right. Thank you.
Ooh.
New world unlocked. Fill out your album. Oh, literally. That's okay. Let's check it out quick. Dark world. An enemy we've never seen before. Yes, it was. Yeah. Huh. Alright. Quest. Here we go. Should be up ahead. Let's go. There it is, the lamp. This is it. Stay and help Vidar. You can't be serious. Do you know what they're doing? They're stealing items that are vital to maintaining each world's order. Who knows what that'll do to the worlds? It's not right. Yes, taking the items upsets the balance of the worlds. But what we're hoping to find is true light that shines even in the face of confusion and uncertainty. So you're using the worlds for your plan. I'm willing to do anything if it's a means to defeating darkness. Wouldn't you, Ericus? I agree that we need to banish darkness, but at what cost? We've defeated countless dark entities the old-fashioned way. Why go this far? In order to defeat true darkness, we need to gather 7 lights. We need to replace the lights that we've lost. A task with which we have Thor's help. I don't have a clue about true darkness and how much of a threat it is. But upsetting each world's order is the worst thing you could do. Don't upset the order. That's what we were taught too. To prepare for the Mark of Mastery exam, you will travel to the worlds beyond to broaden your horizons. There you will observe all manner of order. Some you may not comprehend, but you must still respect. You must not disturb the balance. Even if it's rooted in darkness, yes, you do not yet possess the ability to distinguish between light and shadow. But we've already learned so much. Yeah, more than enough to go and knock some sense into anyone who thinks they know better. Don't be rash. We must proceed carefully. Even if being careful costs us time we don't have. I don't think we'll need to worry about anything. I believe in the light in people's hearts. We were so focused on what we were taught that we lost sight of what was important. What was that? Our friends, the ones of light that were supposed to fight with us. They're gone, and they're never coming back. And to make sure their efforts weren't in vain, we need to defeat darkness at any cost. Ericus, we want the same thing. So I ask of you, take this and find light that's strong enough to accomplish our shared goal. I want to banish darkness, and I'm willing to do anything. At least, I thought I was. Thinking of what it might cost scares me. Maybe I'm not prepared for this after all. It's okay, Ericus. None of us have the knowledge or experience to decide. When you do eventually become a Keyblade Master, you may find yourself having to make this very same decision, and maybe then you'll know what to do. Xehanort's right. This is too much for any of us. Xehanort, you guys. Thank you. We're in way over our heads. Let's go talk to Master Odin. Wait, but what about Jafar? He's waiting for us. So, who cares? Yeah, it's best we steer clear of him. That's it? One year later. So, yeah, it wards off darkness. It's useful. Told ya. So, how'd it go? The tour. I learned the reason for my existence. Oh? Tell me more. all around the world, people live seemingly peaceful lives. They believe themselves to be moral and virtuous, but it's all an act. Darkness lurks in the pit of everyone's heart. Their light is a total farce. Sounds like your trip around the world opened your eyes, but you got a little bit more than you anticipated. Must have seen a lot of darkness. Those who are weak and who desire greater power simply strip the strong of their power and convince themselves they've earned it. That's how people become tainted by darkness. They believe what they want to believe, using hollow reasons as justification. They repeat this cycle, and their darkness grows. So you're saying the weak feel the need to justify their actions, to maintain a sense of self. Can't let that slide. Nope. It's better they be ruled by darkness. People carry delusions of having power, but it's a lie. They are but sheep, pretending to be wolves. Though I admit, I can understand why. Oh, never heard that one before. A keyblade wielder willing to side with the darkness? Why not just let them be until the darkness consumes them? Because left alone, the world would fall to chaos. There needs to be order. Are you sure about that? Why not just sit back and watch it play out? Understanding hearts is difficult, more so the emotions within. I simply realize that it's easy to dismiss what you don't comprehend. All right. The world needs you. I'll grant you that one. I don't know what I can do, but I will act. What comes next is too important. I suppose letting false light dictate the future might be a pretty lousy move. So, you can make a change. You have that power. What do you want for the world? Power. And who knows? My training's coming to an end, and the exam's not far off. Maybe I can gain some clarity then. You're letting the exam decide? Listen to me. The results don't matter. You believe the world needs you. Sounds like you already know where you're headed. It's funny. Somehow I can sense where I'm supposed to go and what I'm supposed to do. Yes, even this coat, there's something familiar about it. As if I'm meant to wear this. No, you'll ditch it soon. What do you mean? I mean, that one day you're going to outgrow it. How so? If you truly possess great power, the darkness can't control you. You won't need a silly old coat to stay safe. In fact, you'll be the one controlling the darkness instead. Me, on the other hand, I'm too much of a scaredy cat to ever take mine off. Who are you, really? Some kind of fortune teller? Well, I could lie and tell you that's what I am, when I'm actually a brilliant artist or even a scholar. I could tell you that I dream of world peace, when I'm actually planning for its destruction. The truth is what you see with your eyes, not what you hear. So, your name? What? Did I just... Never mind. I guess there's no harm. My name is... I'm a lost master. Lost master? May your heart be your guiding key. Episode 6, Uncertain Order, End. Next episode 7, Reason for Disappearance. HP. 65 years later. The corridors of darkness. Bridges that connect each and every world. Destinations near and far are but a brief trek away. But it comes with a hefty cost. These halls are not to be traversed by the living, but by spirit and emotions. They gather here, their hearts drawing in others. Those who attempt to embrace these emotions find their hearts become corroded until they are overcome by darkness. That is why these coats are essential. But those words of caution are for the weak. I believe that a heart strong enough can withstand the strain. I suppose this is of no concern to someone who's closed off their heart. My first mentor taught me of the child of destiny who can connect their heart to others and feel what they feel. So I must embrace these emotions, let them flow into my heart. Will I finally be deemed worthy? Yep, Birth by Sleep. What a great game. Seems you've settled in. Well enough. You've taken on apprentices. They seem quite bright. Better late than never. You mentioned in your letter that you had one of your own. Yes. But Ericus, there's no need. Your letter said enough. Water under the bridge. So, is that him? The one you wish to entrust to my care? Yes. His name is Ventus. You will not train him yourself? I took him under my wing this past year, but I think he may be the child of destiny. Who's sure? Yes, he's a special boy. One who deserves to be guided. True heir to light, I stand too close to the darkness. Could he really be? Screams, what? Episode 7, Reason for Disappearance. I see, Vidar is gathering light as a means to repel true darkness. Yes, he's disrupting the balance of different worlds in an attempt to unearth true light. Master Odin, our task was to search for the missing upperclassmen, but now that we know their intentions, we're beginning to feel like we might be in over our heads. And then there's Vor. She has sided with Vidar. Yes. I know it looks bad, but Vor's just trying to do what she thinks is right. I understand why she's doing it. What I don't understand is how this threat could be so great. that Vidar can justify ruining the order of different worlds. What exactly is true darkness? An enemy of Keyblade Builders from long ago. The Heartless who fight, the ones with form, are beings that were born from it. Is it a type of Heartless? If it was, we could defeat it like all the others. But I'm guessing you think there's more to it. An enemy of Keyblade Builders, Heartless with form. Then, true darkness must have no form. If that's true, how do we defeat something like that? To the best of our knowledge, true darkness itself has never been vanquished. However, the actions taken by the Lost Masters led us to believe that if this darkness has already chosen a vessel to inhabit, defeating it is indeed possible. And the vessel? A necessary sacrifice. No. I can't let that happen. There has to be something we can do. Though it may be difficult to accept, this world of darkness cannot be won without grief and loss. We've already lost enough. If we lose anyone else, I won't be able to face my friend. There has to be another way. Perhaps there is, but it is barred from use. Barred? Are you referring to Kingdom Hearts? We learned about the existence of such a power, but not much else. It is an enigma, about which we know little, yes. However, we do know the steps to summon it. According to legend, 7 lights are the key, but no ordinary ones will do. Only by gathering 7 true lights that shine amidst the darkness of chaos, Kingdom Hearts reveal itself. True light that shines in the darkness of chaos. It is said that to call upon this power is to purge the worlds. Yet it is unclear whether darkness would be abolished in the process. Whatever the outcome, it is an extreme approach that is certain to have a profound effect on every world. Is one life worth the cost? Kingdom Hearts. Remember, it is forbidden. What we know of the great power is merely speculation. Instead, we must focus on studying the darkness and its nature. Kingdom Hearts. Kingdom Hearts. Its power can purge everything. Even darkness that has no form would likely be destroyed. However, it has not yet been determined that what we face now is true darkness. And if it is indeed so, will you risk the lives of countless others to save your friends? It could even purge the worlds. Hermod, you made the right decision coming to me. This is a matter you are not equipped to handle. It is in my hands now. As of this moment, you are relieved from your duty. The Dark Seeker will finally be upon us. So, what now? You heard Master Odin. It's over. Back to our normal lives. You don't look too happy about that. Of course I'm not. Like he said, what Vidar is trying to do is way bigger than us, and bigger than Vor, too. She's probably in over her head. But there's nothing we can do. Master Odin was clear. Our task is over. what are we supposed to do? Easy, take a deep breath, or something. Even if we wanted to go after them, the gates closed, and we wouldn't even know where to go. The only reason we ran into them is because they were keeping tabs on us. So the odds of seeing them again are the same, even if we stay. Maybe so, but we can't just sit here. Well, don't throw a tantrum. Just knowing that Vidar might be messing with the world at this very moment makes me want to go out there and do something. If there's something we can do, we should do it. I thought you wanted to wait and see. Master Odin said he'd deal with the situation. It's not up to us to get involved. Do you think this new threat has anything to do with the upperclassmen who disappeared? Vidar said something about not wanting his friend's efforts to be in vain, and he said true darkness needed to be defeated. So the two have to be connected. Maybe we can look into it and find a way to help. Maybe. But where will we even start? We can't talk to Vidar, and our second best option would be to talk to the people who aren't here anymore. That sounds tricky. Alder, we haven't seen you in ages. Did you just get back? It hasn't been that long. What have you been up to? Not much. I was tasked with finding out more about darkness. You were? Yeah. Apparently, there are different types, so I checked out a few worlds with recent activity, but enough about that. Want to fill me in on what you were talking about? I don't even know where to start. I'm guessing whatever's got you worked up has something to do with Vore, seeing as she's not here. My oh my. So, in order to find out what prompted Vidar to take things this far, you want to gather information from the upperclassmen who disappeared, is that it? I was joking. I mean, that's impossible. What if it's not? Seriously? In one of the worlds I visited, there was this place called the Underworld. You might be able to talk to them there. Great. Then we can continue our task. Really? Ericus? You weren't supposed to know about our assignment to find the upperclassmen. What assignment? Anyway, you don't have to worry about finding Hodor anymore. What? What do you mean? She's tried to protect me, and now she's gone. So the upperclassmen that Vidar said disappeared, one of them was my sister. Ericus, do you remember our talk about the Mark of Mastery exam? We were standing right here. Afterwards, I still couldn't shake the feelings. Something was wrong, so I followed her. Leave my sister alone. Oh, Balder, what are you doing here? Hodor! It's okay. I'll protect you. Balder. No, if he hadn't been there, she could have lived, probably. I don't know what happened after that. When I woke up, I was in the infirmary. Master Odin told you guys that he had a different task for me, but he was just giving me time to heal. Are you okay? Yeah, I'm fine. But I do need to find out what led to all this. Let's go to the underworld. What? We're going? Yep, of course. You heard the man.
All right.
Coliseum or Olympus Coliseum? This is it. It's not as creepy as I thought. No, we're not there yet. Maybe it's through there. I think the other way. So, this is the underworld? Or not. Right, I knew that. Just checking to see if you knew. Where is the underworld then? We're on a platform surrounded by seats. It's like this is a... Welcome to the games. Whoa, who's there? Name's Hades, Lord of the Dead, aka Lord of the Underworld, a place you all are apparently dying to see. So I'm here to offer you a deal. What kind of deal? Win the tournament, and I'll send you a personal invitation to my domain. Win and we get an invite? Got it. Not so fast. A tournament has to have rules. Rule 17. Three people to a team. So that's me and... If I choose Ericus, you're gonna tag along, right, Xehanort? Then that's three. Last and certainly least, huh? Aw, come on. It's not like that. A little... All right then, let the games begin. Hey, and put on a good show, will ya? Oh, that's one split. Hey, look at that. Swaying spook.